Where do you
start now? And now.
Well, I'm sure most of us went to public schools saying dressed up in our own individuality, but I'm sure a little bit of us went to private school and got to experience wearing school uniforms. And most of you guys probably hate wearing school uniforms, or even having the thought of having school uniforms. Well, today I would like to enlighten you about the positive benefits of implementing school uniforms in public schools. I will talk about how it increases equality, discipline students, and how it would help with students academically. First of all, it increases equality because it will reduce peer pressure and bullying. According to the National Association of Elementary School Principal, said that 86% reduction of peer pressure when they implemented school uniform in their school, and 64% reduction of bullying. And you kind of wonder what bullying and peer pressure ties along with school uniforms. Well, if everyone dressed alike, people will be less peer pressured to look a certain, like someone else, in order to fit into a clique, into the social of schools. And with bullying, students get bullied for not having, you know, the latest fashion, or they dress ugly, or they don't dress like someone else. And the next one is that it will help students with dress code. With public schools, a lot of girls, you know, wear short shorts, short skirts, and with implementing school uniforms, it will help apply with the dress code policy. And then according to the National Association of Elementary School Principals, saw that 90% saw an increase of attendance, because if you have uniform, you already know what to wear the next day. And so it helps with battling with what to wear in the morning. It saves time in the morning. Also, a person who did a study whether implementing school uniform will help with behavior in school saw that, according to Dorothy Harris, implementing school uniform helps behavior in school, meaning that there was a decrease in behavior problems because students were easier to be identified, and parents can just easily go to the school and complain about that student. So students were more aware that they have to behave more carefully when they're in school and outside of school. And then also, I know that most people don't like school uniforms because they can't express their individuality. Well, with school uniforms, you can still express your individuality. You can put your makeup on, you can change your hairstyle the way you want it to be different from others. You can change the style of the school uniform. You can wear like a neon jacket with your uniform to make it different than everyone else. So today I talked to you guys about the positive benefits of school uniforms, of how it can increase equality and how it can discipline students, and how it can help with academically.
Thank you.
let me see. Christine, what did you think?
Well, I liked the speech. She knew she was talking about, although there were some pauses. But she did have references to like the national school principal, so she did have some stats on a lot of the positives of school uniforms. You know, I really don't like school uniforms, but she does also say that you can still show some expression, like changing your hairstyle or putting on makeup or her grand speech. Introduction, she kind of does like dive in the speech. So, but overall, she had good eye contact, and I thought the speech was good.
Okay. Yeah, I think of the visualization at the beginning, you need something a little bit more compelling and interesting, and something that will also bring us emotionally into the speech. You know, it's just a general view that you've got there that you think people are going to share, and it's not a bad thing, it's just I'm not sure that it's all that compelling. There's a bit of a preview. I think your preview needs to be a little bit more detailed, and as I'm listening to the structure of the speech, basically it centers around the idea of peer pressure, you know, dress code, behavior, and individuality. Those things, I think, were highlighted as you got to each point, but they feel a little bit like they are bullet points rather than their own individual points. Some of them don't get very developed, and some of the proof that you're using to develop them was a little bit confusing. For example, the behavior in the schools thing, you basically talked about how parents would be able to identify kids in some way, shape, or form. And I didn't understand how that had anything to do with kids' behavior in school. It was not clear at all. The earlier information that you had, I thought there were some good citations. I do think you need to be a little bit more specific on some of those points. But I was interested. I could understand how you could measure bullying, for instance, if you have fewer incidents. But how do you measure peer pressure? You know, and they've got a statistic that says there was a 67% reduction in peer pressure. And I'm going, how did they get that? Or how does a principal reach that assessment? Or they believe that that's true? What did they see that was not occurring in the past? I just think there needed to be some details in the research that you're presenting there that makes it a little bit more credible. Let's see. Delivery issues. I think you've got a pretty good variety in your voice. Your eye contact's very good. I do think you talk to the audience. I did notice, and you probably will now notice it and think it's kind of weird, you may not have thought about it before, you basically thrust your hip out to one side and speak, you know, kind of in this mannered pose for the whole presentation, and that looks a little bit unnatural. When you watch it, I think you'll see what I'm talking about. You know, it just looks a little awkward, and maybe a little bit of movement would help you seem more natural then. All right, thank you.